but 98% of the population has a TV in the house. And in marketing, if you want to get message trusted, you should be negative 71. With Facebook being slow, the uptake or adoption of Facebook is down from a more medium of communication media. Okay, if you're looking at an audience from 15.5, has way more reach than any other channel, medium, program. That's Facebook. And then it becomes a question of more how you are. It's so much different between the shop and Facebook and media. So,
series of vehicles on the installations.
Okay. Does that interest you? Why does that interest you?
Like something like this. The present business behind is something.
It's related to your business, so yeah. It helps you with
to get the information which is in the market.
Okay. Any other radio?
Yeah.
Choose which kind of content you create. But it's essentially what you're doing is you're creating a fly trap here and attracting the flies. So all your money goes into creating this amazing page, destination, site. And I'm hoping that these flies will come and land. The moment they land on page, you think you can give the right to do it. So, just show you some stuff for you. This is our latest advertising. Want to watch TV? Let's go first. In terms of how much TV is coming from you. Content here, creating things. like us get stuff on their wall. They think it's cool, they share it with their friends. Okay? This is another kind of thing we've done. It's the top 10 rated games we've done in the community. So we each of us is bigger gaming. And the narration is done similar. And done. So kids tune in, watch this, download the app. They consume data and no, we get money. That's okay. However, this is not what helped us win the game. Okay? And this is where things like social media usage and understanding customers, how they behave, really ramped up. So what I'm going to teach you is something none of our competitors know. So what social media does, you work with companies like Google and Facebook. You heard of the famous Cambridge Analytica system, incident with Donald Trump. You know that? So you basically do what Cambridge. So we have this segment. This is 2.0. How many of you like getting posts from companies? Like Airtel or No one does. No one likes to get messages from a company pushing back. We have to be sold to people. People don't like, if you really like insurance, they're in your cargo, in your bill on a Sunday, you know, you say you have something great. That's essentially what's happening online. People just instantly. However, you will go to Azam, you will go to. People who you think have no vested interest, correct? You go to those pages, you think it's authentic. So there's a big premium that consumers pay on unbiased, authentic content, which is not manipulated or influenced by advertisers. The truth is non-existent. But the trick is how you can take it. Okay? So for example, you can buy content to try to deal with and get into push content. You can try to deal with your employees for okay, get them to push content. These are third party that you work with and push content. I'll give you a great example, something that has worked really well for us. Did you go to a page called smile.lk? Yeah. No, just have a look at it. So they create content, it's exclusively local content. They do stories, you know, pranks, funny pranks. Very popular on series. And hugely successful with big fun. Okay? Now, we take this target group, okay? And we look at what's called influencer. So this could be a key channel like someone. It could be this could be this could be let's say Kumar Sanda. This could be an aspect of fashion. And this could be fashion too. Okay? Now all of these on the face of it are not
push a video from our side. It generally gets rejected. Okay, but this group is way more receptive to content pushed by this guy. Okay, correct? So what we do is now traditionally this doesn't work anymore. So we collaborate. We have a group of friends actually. Okay, let's say St. Joseph's College some good boys. Yeah. We use that as your medium of communication. And that's how it works. And this is what we really work. Segmented, the more you focus, the easier it is to create content, to create communication. Okay. How would you segment this way? Do you know how many people are on the internet? No? Yes. How many Facebook users we have? So we have roughly about 8 million Facebook users. If I were to ask you, how do they access Facebook? Is it through one of these? One of these.
screen layout. This is a vertical layout. Okay, three of me. This one is horizontal. Okay. So what are the connotations of that? So initially it's design. Okay. If it's design, traditionally you design anything to look color. Layouts of websites and things like that. So we have the website completely designed for this website. Okay? And the fact that everything is not touched. Okay? So it means layouts that you can scroll up and down. Layouts that you can scroll left and right. Okay. Layouts where you can, it's a very simple. You don't have more than one or two scrolls up. Okay. So the thing is, there's a term where in two or three clicks you should get to any one. If you don't, people are just, it's just a design just to change. Your vertical things. Design vertical based advertising. So you create advertisements like this, this is our horizontal ad. It looks shit on the vertical ad. So you start thinking on how you lay this out. So one of the things we do is, or one great example of segmentation is when we did realize that people were accessing the goals. Right? We created ads. See the apply now button? Okay. So when you watch this ad on your phone, okay, at the end, you have the option to order the seat by just clicking on the phone. And then you capture your phone number, okay, so you fill out a few details, two or three details. And the same thing. Same thing in terms of when you want to do a recharge. Just click. So when you can touch functions make it really easy for the customer to get access up. So when we advertise on social media, the whole transaction should be completed online. We don't want him to look at something and then get up and go to the train or the grocery store or the communication outlet to be. You want to do a recharge, you can do it straight away, click over. You want to buy a SIM, you can buy it straight away, click over. The other paradigm that's changing is generally we have a TV and you look at the TV and it is connected to the gun. Or discount at this outlet. That's redundant. I can't say connected to the gun anymore. It doesn't work. I have to give him an option to transact. So what's happening? This is now morphing into a single world. It's not a place to communicate, it's a place to transact. So we're looking at end-to-end transactions online. Are there any questions so far? Or how do you measure success on any campaign on social media? How do you engage? Clicks, likes, share, comments, visits,
feedback.
Yeah, feedback. So, translated to actions, the answer is this, traditionally Facebook pages were ranked based on how many people have liked it. Okay, the page with the most like were considered the ones with the, you know, that are working there. So we have about 7,500 people, 724,000 people who actually like the page. Okay? This is not the stat that we look at. Okay, we work with Facebook. There are other stats that are way more important. It's not how many people are on your page, it's how many people are doing business on your page. So when you work with Facebook, generally you have to work either with Facebook or Google. So Facebook owns the Facebook platform, Google owns everything outside. Okay? The ways you work with them are the same. You give the target audience, they tell you where they are, you push it out. So Google more or less is on YouTube and what you do on YouTube. Facebook is what you do on Facebook. That's a good question. Between YouTube and Facebook, where do you think kids spend more?
YouTube.
You also consume more data. What time of day? Huh? What time do you think is peak time for internet usage in Sri Lanka? Huh? 1 is where people consume the most amount of GB. Okay? But that's a huge connotation on how you advertise. Where you advertise and what kind of thing. You look at TV, peak time is 7:30 to 9. You look at radio, it's morning drive time, 7 to 8. And evening drive time 5 to 7. Completely different. Okay? So these are advertising. It was different at 12 to 1 in the night than 7 to 9 or the evening and 7 to 9 in the morning. Decided the time of day in the car. What is different about that? Is what's different from a guy who's consuming media at 12 o'clock in the night to a guy who's consuming media at say 7:30 to 8 in the evening or 8:30 in the morning? Okay, do you guys watch TV now, right? Never watch TV. Who lives with their parents? No one has a still with the parents. Okay, so parents have owned the TV. You get to watch TV with them?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, so explain
generally TV is consumed as a
good.
So you have either your father, your mother, or your sister, brother, or your friend watching TV. Radio, in the morning, either drive to work or to the train, is coming. At 12 in the night, it's just you and the internet. You and the internet. What's different about that mindset versus the other mindset?
Right.
So, privacy is one main thing. What does that mean? Because you have total privacy, what is that? People are actually themselves, honest, and very brutal about what they want and purpose. Whereas you can run an ad, you can pay a channel to run an ad at 7:30 and you will have to watch it. Or you can get up and go and you say this. Same with the radio, you are stuck in that car, or with your phone plugged on in the train or in the radio bus. You have no choice. Very different. To get wrong, people are very unfair. Okay? What does it do? What does it do? Generally, TV commercials are, I tell you, if my product is great, buy it, it's the cheapest in the market, or it's the fastest in the market. You don't have to do anything about it. Radio is the same. You get an easier assessment. Go to Airtel, they have the fastest. I've used the app, you should try it. What happens when you do it here? People can come and call you up and say, that's nice. So what happens when you communicate on these, you will be extra careful. You have to be very honest, truthful, and be prepared to handle instant. This is an instant video. If I make a comment, if I send you a silly request, if I ask you to fix something, I don't want someone calling me back next Monday. I want a chat to pop up like that, and someone to be on it, and to talk to me in the next minute. So that's changing the way business is done. So you have to have customer service guys now after 1 in the morning. So our customer service peak time is also the sales. And more on to chats. People are moving away from calling a call center. They're picking chat buttons. They don't want to visit stores. They want solutions only. So we structure business sources to be safe. So if you have a automobile business online, someone wants a spare part, most likely it's going to deliver to everyone out there. This one can be given. Be able to answer him in the two to 3 months. Okay? So the business place, a place where you can be competition. And that is what we have done in the last 2 years, which we have got right. Okay? Which the competition is just at. So a lot of you have come and said from Ansara, from Matthew, from that. They're consuming huge amounts of information, spending a lot of time showing their Facebook pages or watching videos. Okay? And you need to service them. So we put all our money on TV and on this. It's unnoticeable to you because unless you're targeted, you won't get this money. So this kid. Questions?
big conversation for you guys if you are looking for employment. These are skills that are very important. Very, very important. Okay? So having a great understanding, not just on being a consumer on social media, but using social media, how do you market, how do you leverage all your teams in marketing online, what's different about this medium to the traditional way. So these things are still, I mean, I think, I don't know what you guys do, but it's not really taught in MBAs, in BSc programs, but it's a big skill. It has a lot of depth, okay? And it's counted up in on the website. How to market, understanding that. So the fundamentals are the same, understanding a target audience, segmenting it properly, their needs, their wants, that fit has to be back. But the communication, the way you design, the way you transact, has just changed our needs. Let's have a passive media is way of doing that. Okay. All right, thanks. Hope you guys.